Everyone has a plan until they get punched in the mouth. What's up, everybody? Welcome to another vlog episode. This episode is gonna be short and sweet and not the average vlog that I usually do. I wanna share you guys an experience that I had last week that has happened to me time and time again. And I want to bring this to the table because I know that a lot of other people, whether it's business or personal, have gone through this. And I just want to share this experience with you and voice my opinion on it. So last week I had put out some content that was miscommunicated and also some of the facts deemed to be incorrect. Obviously not on purpose. However, I'm not going to get into detail of the situation or who the person was. But a colleague had reached out to me and had let me know that what I was doing was wrong. Communicated with me and let me know how he felt. And I did not take it with a grain of salt because this person I look up to and I aspire to be. And I am very thankful that I have met this person in my life. So that is the reason why I had to take down an episode and re-edit it, take some stuff out and kind of finesse it to take any of that information out, and now it is finally reposted. Vlog 8 is up. If you haven't seen it, check it out after this one. But it brought back an old feeling that has happened time and time again in my professional and business life that I want to shed some light on. After I had this experience, I became overwhelmed with a huge rush of humiliation. And in a lot of cases, a lot of people don't know how to handle that kind of humiliation or shame or failure. But there is a silver lining to everything. I am a huge fan of humiliation and failure. So in light of this learning lesson, I'm gonna head over to Huntington Beach and share more with you my experiences in humility and failure and why I can't live without it. Now, a lot of people like to look at this word in a negative aspect, but by definition, humility means a modest or low view of one's own importance, humbleness. Now, being new to the business of real estate, I actually have become best friends with humility and failure, because what I've learned so far in the business is without those two things, there is no growth. Even the most successful and seasoned agents in this industry will tell you the same thing. They did not get to where they are from not failing. And whether you're 6 months in the business, 5 years, 10 years, even 20, you're still constantly learning new things to be better. Now, I really like to believe that humiliation and failure started in my life right when I decided that I wanted to be a heavy equipment operator and start doing excavation. Reason being that I was super young, I felt like I knew what I was gonna be doing in the machines and that I should just get into a $100,000 backhoe and just start digging. Fortunately, I learned from the greatest boss of all time when it comes to operating, and that was a man named Bo Dyer. He owned WLD and Sons, which is one of my very good and old friends, Steve Dyer's father's excavation company. Hi. Hello! And when I started working for the man, I soon found out how it really is to be humbled. When instead of letting me in the machine, obviously, he put a shovel on my hand and told me to get in the trenches. With a mix of my dedication to learn the trade and his brutal honesty, I probably would not have the work ethic that I do and apply in everything that I have going on for me today. So Bo, if you're watching or if you ever see this, thank you so much, man. I love you, and I gotta come visit you. After a while, I earned my ranks to a heavy equipment operator, and I stayed in that trade for about 12 years. But I felt like the challenges weren't getting hard enough, and I wanted something new, and that's when I jumped into sales. When I had gotten into sales, I then applied the work ethic that I had through learning through excavation and heavy equipment operating to my sales and learning how to be a better salesperson. The only way that I was able to become a great salesperson at that time was from learning, keeping my head low, and constantly failing forward and correcting myself. Again,
always staying humble. And another learning lesson, which a lot of people find out, is when I had transferred over to California to do sales out here, again, that's when the humiliation hit me big time. It was a whole different animal, and I wasn't as good as I actually thought I was, and got corrected and corrected and corrected. Failure after failure. Through a mix of that and the daily rejection that comes in sales, you have to understand that this can really change the perspective, really take down the ego and pride in someone. With humiliation, I learned to be comfortable with being uncomfortable, which led me into different types of sales, such as digital marketing, real estate coaching, and eventually, real estate. And when going through each of those industries, I had my fair share of fuck-ups, failures, learning curves. And if I could go back to change anything, to tell you the truth, I wouldn't change anything at all. Which brings us to my current situation. When it comes to doing these videos, doing vlogs, creating content, or building my business as a real estate agent, 6 months fresh into the industry, I have had a ton of failure. However, I've gotten a lot of support from people when it comes to doing this, or my brokerage helping me out with certain situations in real estate. And it's been a little bit since I've gotten a good gut check. So I gotta tell you, what happened last week actually feels really good. At first I was nervous, I had a little bit of fear right at my spine, but it's for the good. And I understand that now, and I take things at a much deeper level and perspective than I did before. And I'm very thankful that I'm able to see it that way, because some people don't. Some people find it insulting. Some people hide away and never branch out or learn from it, and it stops the motivation or inspiration of what they want to do. And if you're going through that kind of humiliation where it feels like such a stab that you just want to give up, that you don't want to pursue what you were going for, or you kind of lose passion, your vision of what you wanted to become, I have some advice for you. So, humility and failure, when looked at correctly, can be seen as very strong stepping stones when it comes to personal or business growth. So not if, but when you get smacked by failure and you get humiliated, whether it's on your own terms or somebody has communicated this to you, always remember this, that without those two things, you are not able to correct yourself in order to fine-tune who you are as a person and be better tomorrow than you are today. I embrace it, I love it, I learn from it, and it makes me stronger than I've ever been. So I actually wanna take this time to thank my colleague that had reached out to me last week. You know who you are, you're probably seeing this. I just wanna say thank you. Really, you're a huge inspiration. I look up to you, I see everything that you're doing huge things, and I hope that one day my hard work pays off and I can be at the same level that you're at. You're awesome, dude. Thank you so much for understanding. And shout out to all the underdogs out there going through humiliation, going through failure. Don't stop, keep pushing, and I promise you, good things are happening. That is it for the vlog. I love you guys. Thank you so much for the support and the love. If you haven't seen past episodes, please check them out. And if you haven't yet, please subscribe and like. Comment below, let me know what your take on humiliation is, what your take on failure is. What do you love about it? What do you hate about it? I want to know. I want to hear your feedback. Let me know. And I will see you next week.